Hello, happy Sunday to you, and I'm excited that you are part of what God is doing today because you are alive. And I know that that which the Lord has prepared for you today, every blessing will surely come your way in the mighty name of Jesus. Today, I'm so excited because we are looking at something very important as a reminder to all of us that are believers that there is authority of God in us. Sometimes we are forgetting what God is saying, but today the Lord is using our Father in the Lord to tell us that there is authority for every believer if you can key into it. And our topic today says, ye shall decree a thing. Ye shall decree a thing. There is power that backs up decree. And I'm trusting God that at the end of this, broadcast today, you will enter into that dimension of where you will become very prophetic about everything that the Lord has prepared for you, and you begin to get results in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's pray. Father, we want to thank you, our Jehovah Nissi, our Jehovah Jireh. Thank you for showing us many expressions of you this week. And we pray as we go into your word, you will open our eyes of understanding to take our rightful place and begin to decree, to see things come into reality in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Welcome back once again. And our memory verse today is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 11, verse 23. And I'll read to you very quickly. It says, For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe that those things which he said shall come to pass, he shall have whatsoever he said. Very profound word of God. He's saying, if you believe in your heart and trust the Lord, and if you don't have any doubt, he said, that which you ask will surely come to pass. Can I ask you a question? When last did you decree anything? When last did you decree anything? Our Father, the Lord showed us today the importance of making decree. Our text is taken from the book of Job, chapter 22, verse 23 to 30. Job 22, verse 23 to 30. There are different kinds of prayers. There is prayer of supplication. There is prayer of intercession. Our Father in the Lord showed us today that there is a need to switch from those prayers into a prayer of decree. You get to a point in your life that you cannot afford but allow that to happen. What's the difference between those prayers? When you pray a prayer of supplication, you can beg in that kind of prayer. You can say, please, let this happen. But when it comes to the prayer of decree, you must not take no for an answer. It is a point where you don't allow the devil to go scot-free. It is the way you want it to happen. That is the way you decree it by the power of the Holy Ghost that is rested upon you. Let me ask you, you who don't know your right, and that is why you are still staying you are still making some certain kind of prayers. When you know your right in God, when you know the power you carry, when you know that who is in you is greater than that who is in the world, you will not beg the enemy. You will not say, please, witch, leave me alone. Oh, the devil, please run away from me. Oh, don't kill my child. Oh, don't take over my business. Don't ruin my life. That is not the kind of prayer you pray. You decree and the devil will flee from you. You will decree and ask the enemy to take their hands off everything that concerns you. Can I make a decree to your life? No matter how you have suffered in the past, it doesn't matter how much you have been deprived or you have been cheated. It doesn't matter whatever the devil is doing right now. I decree in the name that is above every other name, that in the name of Jesus, the devil takes his hand off you in the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall he be in the name of Jesus. The Bible says in the book of Mark chapter 24 that we hear, it said, therefore, I say to you, whatsoever ye desire, when ye pray, believe that ye receive them, and ye shall have them. If you believe, you will receive. I want to decree one more time. Whatever your heart desire, I make a decree in the name of Jesus. That which you desire of the Lord will come to pass in the name of Jesus. That is it. A prayer of decree creates an atmosphere where you cannot take no for an answer. It's a more often than none. Not only those who walk, and this is for only those who walk intimately with God. That's the condition. You must be knitted with him. Am I so sure? Isaiah chapter 45 verse 11. Isaiah 45 verse 11 says, thus saith the Lord, the Holy One of Israel and his maker, ask me of things to come concerning my sons And concerning the work of my hands, command ye me. Only the sons and the daughters of God can command God to do certain things. If you don't belong to Him, oh, that is not a good news. Because you will just be making noise. That your decree won't come to pass. He won't honor those words because you don't belong to Him. But the good news today is that you have the opportunity to switch from that management to a new management where you can command the Lord to do something for you. What do you need to do? It's to submit to His Lordship. It's very interesting. When you are saying, God, I submit to you, help me. And at the process of helping you, He will fight your battles for you. In fact, you will sit back and see the Lord fighting for you. And that will be your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Something very interesting happened in the book of Ezekiel chapter 37. Ezekiel chapter 37. God told the prophet Ezekiel that, look at this bone. What do you think of it? The man is very careful. One of my pastors said he was very careful because he saw skull. He saw people who are far dead. You know, sorry, and he doesn't want to join them. He quickly said to God, he said, you are the one that knows. Oh, don't let me go and say the wrong thing there and become these people that are here. But he got to a point when the Lord opened his eyes to discover what responsibility has been placed upon his hand. And he said, decree concerning this thing, and then come back to life. And the Bible says, as he made those decrees, he said, bones to bones, flesh to flesh begin to come. I want to pray for you as you begin to decree right where you are concerning that problem, concerning that issue. I see everything working together for you in the mighty name of Jesus. If you believe it, you shall receive. He said, if you don't doubt in your mind, you will say to the mountain, be thou removed, and it will move. Every mountain blocking your destiny, every mountain is a prophetic teaching, every mountain stopping you today, those mountains are moved in the mighty name of Jesus. Daddy said some years ago, a couple came and was trusting God for the fruit of the womb. And as they approached him to pray, they were discussing or arguing about the sex of the child. This one was saying he should be a boy. The other one says a girl. Daddy said he made a decree that God will give you both a boy and a girl. And they believed God for it and they took it. And then they came back with a twin, a boy and a girl, exactly how my Father in the Lord has pronounced it. Can I decree something into your life? As you listen to this message, whatever you trust of the Lord and you believe in your heart that as this word is coming forth, you believe God to bring it to performance, that will be your testimony in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And he said to us, for us to effectively engage in the prayer of decrees, however, we must abide in Christ. That's the condition. We must belong to God. We must submit to His Lordship. According to John chapter 15 verse 7, this means that we must be born again and live a life in total obedience to God. In total obedience to God. That's how to connect. That's how to enter into that dimension. You must submit to His Lordship. If you had been born again before but fell into sin, now is the time to repent and return back to God so that you can begin to decree as a son, as a daughter of God. He said, our Bible reading today summarizes this message excellently. If you are on the Lord's side, you will decree a thing and it shall come to pass. I am trusting God for as many who is saying today that they want to come to Jesus. The door is wide open. He loves you. He has even paid all the price. And he's saying, I want to receive you. So that you can become my son and my daughter, and you can begin to, you know, smash the edge of the devil. You can begin to decree things and you see them come to pass. I want to pray with you if you are making that decision. That Lord Jesus, I come to you. I submit to your new leadership. I am moving my everything, my possession from the devil, from the camp of the devil. I move all my loads, I move them to you. I come to Jesus under a new management. And as you receive me, Lord, today, I promise never to go back to my sin. I promise never to go back into my old ways in the mighty name of Jesus. If you have just made that prayer, congratulations to you. Right now, you can begin to decree and God will honor it in the mighty name of Jesus. You must be given to the study of the Word of God and also find a Bible-believing church like RCCG to attend. And let your faith increase from where you are in the mighty name of Jesus. We continue our Bible in 1 year in the open heavens. We'll be reading the book of Isaiah chapter 12 all through to chapter 17. And our hymn today says, standing on the promises of Christ, my King. What is our prayer point today as you go? You will cry to God, you say, my Father, I decree according to your word, every mountain threatening my destiny is removed now in the mighty name of Jesus. If you are praying that prayer, pray it wholeheartedly and decree, nothing must stop you, nothing must stop your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. And you shall receive answer to your prayers in Jesus' name. God bless you.